Hello, this is going to be a roundup really of my Rust iced project. So I called it a ice because I thought I'd go up for the alphabet. This is I'll run it, we'll just demo it, and then I'll just go through a couple of things that I wanted to kind of document while it's fresh in my mind. So the window is fixed size now, and when you run it appears, I think it's around about 1400 across and about 200, 300 down, something like that. It's now fetching the Bitcoin price in US dollars and in GBP, pound sterling. It's making an API call to CoinGecko and is returning a tuple, which I'm then splitting up and using in two different places, which two different text objects. Let's look at the code. So I've changed my screen here. Sorry about the SRC is a bit dark. Let's just go into SRC and then I'm on a different computer. This is my older computer. It's slightly quicker actually. Right, I've changed the current price. Before that was based on it was based on an example I'd found on, I think it was unofficial iced examples, and it was fetching the IP of the current machine it was running on. Anyway, message now has refetch, which basically fetches the price or refetches the price, current price. So these are the two kind of the two options, as it were, that you can do. You can either fetch the price or you can it's either fetching the price or it's got the price. F64 for USD and GBP. If we go down, I'll try and explain the bit that I found most alien, should we say, that we're displaying the price in dollars. That's the button in the middle, and then we'll explain the price in pounds. So that's the view. The view, got the spacing and the padding. We're aligning the things in the window to the center of the window. So that's inside the window. At the very end, then we actually move the window across to. I've used this. So again, this video hopefully will help anyone who's kind of got concerns that the older versions of iced have changed anything. So this is the beauty of this video, is that it's done using iced 0.13. So the position, you've got position specific. See, that's an enum. And then you've got point new, and then 1400 across. My screen is 1920, I think, and then 200 down. That's the size. So if we wanted to make it wider, for instance, which is at 600, I'm using run with. Run with allows you to do extra bits, as far as I'm aware. Don't quote me on that, but you'll typically see examples just with that one line where it's got the title, the update, and the view. Once you start adding things, as far as I understand it, you can then use run with. And also, because I'm using tasks. Why am I using tasks? I'm using tasks because I'm doing an async fetch here to get the Bitcoin price from the API. You see how I've just added currencies equals USD, GBP. So then I get a tuple which I can just pass, which I can return. Requests, it's got JSON, or requests understands JSON, so you can deserialize it. Right, let's get to the actual, I wouldn't say the complicated bit, but the different bit to what you might be used to, and that's actually here. We're returning a task perform. So ordinarily, if nothing is happening or everything's completed, you'll get task none and then it's done. But whilst a task is effectively in progress, you'll be using or to create a task perform which does something. When that's finished, it then does message current price, and then it returns current price. So there we go. That's just a quick roundup, and I'll leave that there. But the codes, I'll put a link to the code in this description, and I'll leave the link to the earlier two videos. So thanks for watching. I'll be back soon.